Good evening, everyone. Tonight I'm going to be reviewing for you a classic 80s movie, and it is called Jaws. This was Steven Spielberg's second film, and is regarded by many as one of, if not the greatest thriller ever made. It's like an action kind of adventure thriller. And it stars Roy Schreider, Robert Shaw, and Richard Dreyfuss. Who play a police officer, a doctor, and a shark hunter, who's played by Robert Shaw and is my favorite character. Okay, so let's turn the camera around. Jaws. I just saw this movie a few weeks ago. It's the first time I'd seen it since I was a little kid. It was really cool to see it again. There were a lot of scenes I'd forgotten. One of the major things I'd forgotten about this is how scary the shark is. Even as a kid, the shark gave me nightmares, but especially seeing, not to give it away if you haven't seen it, although I'm sure a lot of you have at this point because it's such a classic, but the shark hunter in it, his death scene, was pretty much the most disturbing thing I'd ever seen in my life, especially seeing it recently. Like, out of every movie I've seen the most violent movies, I've seen horror movies, I've seen, like, everything you can imagine, but, that death really bugged me, just because it looks so incredibly painful. But anyways, let's talk about the movie. What makes Jaws a really good thriller is, more than anything to me, is just how grounded in reality it is. I mean, they were working with a very low budget for this film. The shark in it is, especially at the end, is an animatronic shark, which didn't really function too well. I'm sure a lot of you know the story of how, like, they just couldn't get the shark to work, and it took forever just to get the few shots of the shark that are in the film. Some people complain the shark looks fake at the end, but I really don't think it does. I'm not quite sure why people think that. Maybe a little if you look really closely, but it's a pretty awesome animatronic shark that they use in the film. And for all the other shark footage, they used real shark footage that was shot on the ocean, so, and incorporated it into the movie. Like I said, the movie's very down to earth. All the characters in it are not, you know, your Hollywood hunks or, you know, people that are larger than life. They're very real looking guys. Roy Scheider plays the police officer in it, who, he's the one that investigates the mysterious death of a woman at the beginning of the movie. Her remains are found washed up on a beach. The movie opens with a spectacular scene, and very scary scene, of her going swimming alone while her boyfriend passes out drunk, or the guy she's gonna sleep with passes out drunk on the beach. That's hoping to score with her, and she goes out in the water alone, and there's that iconic scene of her being tugged back and forth by the shark as he, like, thrashes her about in the water. And that's how the film opens, with that very terrifying scene. And so, you know, Officer Brody, played by Roy Schreider, starts to investigate the events. And, you know, he has to deal with this really stupid-ass, like, mayor that doesn't want to close the beaches because he's going to lose a lot of money, even though the shark keeps picking off people one by one, including a little boy later on. Yeah, and later on, in comes Richard Dreyfuss, who plays the an oceanographer who is an expert in sharks, and together they start to investigate what's going on, him and the police officer. The character of Robert Shaw does not come in until much later in the story. There's a wonderful little introduction to him near the beginning of the film, though, shortly after the boy is killed in the water. So it's an awesome introduction. I mean, he is the coolest character in this movie, in my opinion. Even though he only appears in the last 40 minutes or so of the film. But he has a great introduction where, you know, he gives that classic line, you know, this shark swallow you whole. A little shaking, a little tenderizing, down you go. He has the best lines in the whole movie. So as the movie goes on, more and more people get killed, and it, you know, eventually the mayor starts to realize that this is a serious problem, and that people are gonna keep dying if he doesn't do something about it. So they agree to pay the shark hunter, whose name in the film is Quint. They agree to pay him a big amount of money so that he'll go out and hunt the shark and kill it. So he takes the other two guys along with him, the police officer and the oceanographer, and they have this crazy adventure on the ocean where they try to bring the shark down. But of course, the shark is no ordinary shark. Has super strength. It's monstrous. It's very cunning and smart, and ultimately it almost destroys them. There's a huge standoff at near the end of the film where the shark literally comes right up onto the boat and bites into it. The boat starts to sink, and it's so intense. Like, there are no words for how intense that final scene is. Like, it is the blueprint for how to create tension in a film. And of course, this film inspired many other thrillers that came after it. And like I said, not to talk about it too much, but Quint's death at the end of the film—I already mentioned this earlier—is very disturbing, just because of how realistic it is. You know, being eaten by a shark would not be a pleasant thing for anybody, but you know, because a shark's teeth are basically like giant razor blades. So it bites into you. It's excruciatingly painful, and it takes a while for him to die in that scene. And he gives some pretty realistic screams too. Another amazing scene in the film is before Quint gets killed. He talks about what happened when he used to serve with the army, and he was part of the team that was supposed to deliver the Hiroshima bomb during Vietnam. And him and his team end up in an accident where they all go into the water, and one by one they're picked off by sharks until only Quint and a few other people are left. And he witnesses his best friend, bitten in half right in front of him. That's the most amazing speech in the whole film, the famous Indianapolis speech, as many people call it. And it's the moment that really, you know, Robert Shaw, in my opinion, deserved an Academy Award for his performance. He's completely mesmerizing in the role. They're all really good. Richard Dreyfuss adds a lot of humor to the film. There's a humor throughout the film, even though it is a thriller in many ways. The humor is what keeps it from going too far to the dark side, of course. And Richard Dreyfuss is a very funny character, very laid back, very intelligent. You know, he basically comes from a really wealthy family, and he's independently wealthy, so he uses all his money to explore the oceans and investigate sharks. He doesn't get grants from anybody, like, he pays for it all himself. So the cinematography of the film is absolutely stunning. There's lots of amazing shots from inside the water itself, where the camera's kind of between the water and the sky. And lots of kind of dolly kind of motion, camera moves that go straight across. It's just really well filmed, but it's not gratuitous in any way. It's very grounded. Like I said before, very realistic. This isn't done like a big Hollywood epic. You know, it's set in a very small town on a little island, Amity Island, it's called. All the characters, like the secondary characters in the film, are all very realistic as well, and just seem like ordinary people that you might encounter anywhere. Yeah, cinematography is pretty good. You know, nothing too grandiose about it, but it serves its purpose quite well. There's a lot of iconic shots in the film. My favorite shot is near the end of the film, when it's kind of the last ditch effort to try to stop the shark once and for all, after they've been using this method where they're putting barrels into the shark's hide by, like, they shoot like a kind of like a harpoon into the shark's back, and the barrel's attached to the end of a rope. And he takes down a whole bunch of barrels, and near the end, it's, they're starting to all get really afraid and, thinking that they might die. Like, it's so hard to stop this shark. It's just, it keeps outwitting them. And the camera pulls in close on the bow of the ship and then slowly pulls away as the ship kind of goes through the water. And it's a really iconic and amazing shot. And it just has the name Orca, and then you just see it pull away. There's quite a lot of shots like that. Steven Spielberg's really good at that, focusing in on certain moments and making them really profound and epic. But there's nothing grandiose about it. I mean, he's such a good director. Like, his movies are always very visually stunning, and yet, they never have the feel of being really big Hollywood epics. They always look artistic and grounded. So if you haven't seen Jaws yet, I'm not quite sure why you haven't. Especially if you love thrillers, this is a must-see. Like, it's anyone who loves movies, you need to pick this up. I bought this for $5 at my local HMV. Probably get it for a comparable price pretty much anywhere. It's a really iconic and amazing thriller from a really amazing director. I love everything Steven Spielberg's ever done, and this is definitely one of my favorite Steven Spielberg films. Before Jaws came out, no one had ever seen anything like it before. There had never been really a movie about a killer shark before this, and it became a huge blockbuster. I mean, at the time, Jaws became the biggest blockbuster ever, like in history, pretty much. There are some films that surpass that at this point, but at the time, it was the biggest blockbuster the world had ever seen. It d defined the term blockbuster, basically, this film. So, I gotta talk a bit about the musical score. My God, I don't know why I haven't mentioned that yet. Anyone who is aware of great music in films will instantly recognize the theme in this. Da 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 da. The theme plays throughout the film, but it's always done in different ways, so it never feels old or boring. It's just a fantastic musical score that really gives a wonderful sense of tension and brooding dread, especially as the shark's approaching. And there are several moments, too, where the shark suddenly looms into view without any music preceding it at all, which you don't expect it, so it makes it even more shocking. And it's just a brilliant use of tension, this music, and just the absence of music too creates tension, because when everything's still, suddenly something will just happen that you were least expecting, And the shark itself, like I said, it's animatronic for a few shots in the film, and it's a truly impressive looking shark. I mean, I don't think it looks fake. I think it looks quite realistic. Only if you look really closely can you notice that maybe the movement is a little jerkier than a real shark would be. I don't know. But to me, it seems pretty real. And just one more thing I'll say about this. I already mentioned this earlier, but seriously, like, Robert Shaw is so amazing in this film. He's just on fire in his performance in this. He's very driven, obsessed, absolutely fearless because of what happened to him with the Indianapolis, seeing all his friends die in front of him. It made him into a very, determined, fearless, and kind of eccentric and loopy person. He's highly intelligent, though. He's always cracking jokes and singing songs, and he's kind of your typical sea captain, but he's so charismatic as well. And, by the end, his pretty much ruthless determination almost gets all of them killed. So, he ultimately gets what's coming to him by the end, with his death. But it's a fitting death for him, I suppose, considering, he basically was not about to turn back. He was going to get the shark no matter what, even if it meant his own death. So he ultimately pays the price. So yeah, overall, Jaws is an incredible film. Very entertaining, very grounded, very thrilling, very exciting. Great performances all around. Fantastic musical score. It's a great one to watch just for pure entertainment. It's a great movie to watch with a crowd because everyone always reacts a lot, especially during the last few scenes in it. And especially, I'm sure when people saw this in the theater when it came out at first, like in the 80s, I'm sure everybody was cheering like crazy when that shark finally gets what's coming to him in the end. It's pretty spectacular. So, you know what? I might have made a mistake here. I think this movie came out before 1980, didn't it? Not sure. I might be wrong about when this came out. It either came out in the 80s or the 70s. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, so I highly recommend this film. If you're a movie buff, if you like movies, you gotta see it. It's an absolute classic. So that's my review on Jaws. I hope you enjoyed it. And I'll have another review coming up for you very soon. Have a good night, everybody. Bye-bye.